Guess what? We've really scored. Remember I told you that we were going to get a warden interview? Maybe we were crossing our fingers on that. Well, guess what? We have an interview with a warden. In fact, not just any warden, with Warden Spearman of High Desert State Prison, who he asked us if we would come up and bring the GOGI program to High Desert when he was transferred here. We came, we packed our bags, and here we are at High Desert. He wants to ask us some questions. Can you imagine that? So right now, we're going to cut to our interview with Warden Spearman.
How are you, Coach Taylor?
I am so awesome, and I know you haven't eaten. You've been on the facilities. I see you go from one housing unit to the next, one building to the next. I just have to say that you are so amazingly devoted to your occupation, to your skills, and building them with these men. And I'm just so grateful that you asked GOGI to be here. Mm-hmm. We consider it an honor, and I know you have a million and one things to do, so it's even more of an honor that you would give us this time with you on camera. So thank you.
You're welcome.
I love being here at High Desert. It's awesome because we have 4 yards that are actively programming GOGI, but 4 yards that are very, very different. Now, I know you had some questions with regard to that. Like, you aren't in the trenches with us every day as we're handing out GOGI assignments or picking them up. Mm-hmm. What kind of questions would you have as a warden as to what's going on with your GOGI?
Well, I was just wondering kind of what is the response of the population here on all the, maybe we'll start with Alpha Yard. Is there been a good response, or are people apprehensive, and what kind of programs do you have going on Alpha Yard?
Okay, well, I think at first they were curious, and after one or two guys did the courses, some of the courses, they told their friends, and of course, the motivation to get a certificate in a chrono is the impetus to start it.
Yes, it is.
But now we have like awesome leaders. In fact, custody, which they aren't mandated to do this, but custody will let some of the GOGI guys out to the little spider tables to study during the day and do their GOGI groups. And the custody officers are now finding that the GOGI students that come out and sit at the little tables to do it in the day room, they're compliant, they're respectful, they're happier, and they're earning certificates and chronos for doing either their self-study GOGI, in-cell GOGI, or our leaders who come out for our weekly leadership meetings.
Correct.
So we are so happy. We were on A Yard yesterday, as a matter of fact. We took 3 of our leaders, we took a cart, and we distributed more than 500 books.
Oh, wow.
Yes, 500 books.
Is that the book that you gave me as a gift, the green one that says How to GOGI?
Yes.
Okay, 500 books. Okay.
500. So my feeling is that we had at least 490 people open that book up last night and start to read.
Well, that's good to hear.
It's very, very great.
Help these guys make some positive decisions in their lives.
So I would say that we probably have 400 men on A Yard engaged in GOGI in some level.
Okay.
And the talk on the yard, everybody's talking GOGI.
Oh, that is very good to hear. I'm glad. Yes. I appreciate you guys taking a chance on us at High Desert up here on this mountain and coming up here to help us out.
Well, honestly, if you want the honest truth,
yes,
when you told me you were going to High Desert and you said, are you up there? I said, no way. And I remember you said, well, why not? I said, oh, man, I don't know. I don't think they program. I don't think they like programming. And you said, well, I'm headed up there. And I said, okay, Warden, if you're there, GOGI's there. Because I knew if we had you as a warden here, if we had the kind of support that you've always given us, we would have a winning thing. So I placed all my bets and I won.
No, you did.
Yeah, High Desert now is our number 2 institution for the number of chronos in the past 2 years, surpassed only by Pleasant Valley. Pleasant Valley has 4 ill tags and about 600 guys doing GOGI.
Wow.
Okay. But we will surpass them at High Desert. Not that we don't want Pleasant Valley to succeed, but High Desert, we will be surpassed. You went from position 0,
correct,
35, to position number 2 inside of 12 months.
That is excellent. Yeah, I worked at Pleasant Valley. It's always been a premier prison, but we are also our premier prison, and so our population will respond and come along.
Absolutely.
Out in B, our Bravo facility, a little different dinette level 4S and Y, are they interested also?
Incredible interest. In fact, more people are doing in housing unit GOGI on B than anywhere else.
Wow.
You have more small groups being popped out for the spider tables.
Okay.
On B.
On B.
Incredible. And you've got some really solid leadership who really hold all the GOGI members accountable to a very, very high standard.
Mm-hmm.
So they check all the work. No, we are not submitting that to GOGI. That is not good enough. Go back and do it again. So they are really holding everyone up to a high standard. Mm-hmm. When we finally pick up the courses and we do our final review,
yes,
B-Yard, we don't send anything back.
Wow.
Okay. Everything from B-Yard is spot on. The men are holding each other accountable at an extremely high level, which is cool.
Well, that's good to hear. And again, as if the men on B-Yard, my men on B-Yard see this, I want to tell you guys thank you. And you guys should be proud of yourselves for making those accomplishments. And I, as a warden, are proud of those men for doing
yeah,
that on B-Yard.
Yeah, it's cool. And C-Yard,
yeah, how
surprising
C-Yard?
Surprising enthusiasm. Now, unfortunately, they have not been able to meet as a leadership team for about 6 months.
Oh, wow.
Yes.
Okay.
So our leaders have not met, but the interest in the cores, in the cells, and in the housing units,
mm-hmm.
extremely strong. You've had a lot. In fact, in-cell has been your strongest on C-Yard.
On C-Yard, okay.
Yeah, so C-Yard has been doing the most book reports, but, you know, they need that leadership. So we're
correct.
Looking forward to getting regular ILTAG meetings, but your leaders are emerging in the face of a lot of obstacles. Mm-hmm. No day room, no materials, no ILTAG support, no weekly meetings.
Correct.
They're still resilient, saying, we don't care. We're going to keep doing this, which is really a testament to their commitment to really make some changes. Because they, I think C has the greatest obstacles of all your 4 yards.
Mm-hmm.
They have the greatest obstacles.
Hmm. Okay. Well, we'll continue to work with our,
yes.
our you know, community resource manager to
yeah.
get an actual ILTAG sponsor over there.
Yes.
And then get that going back to there. Because I know we're trying to mirror Facility D with C and
yes.
having the in-building
right.
program. And I know facility, we're going to come to Delta right in a minute, but we weren't able to do that because of certain things, but because of their yard schedule.
Right.
But if we have
right.
enough interest in it, we'd like to. But if, like, if we don't have enough interest for in-building, we'll just continue to foster
yeah.
and facilitate in-cell GOGI.
Well, we met and we actually worked with your leaders on C. We
mm-hmm.
actually took them into one of the old chow halls
uh-huh.
that are now being, and we said, okay, this is what we look for.
Mm-hmm.
This is how you look at the work. This
right.
is what we process. And they said, you guys do all this?
Mm-hmm.
Yes, volunteers do all this till late at night, till 11 o'clock at night we're doing this. He said, wow, that's a lot of work. So we train them what to look for. So when they get their leadership meetings, they know exactly what to tell the men. Because, of course, without leadership, we're having to send back a lot of stuff.
Correct.
We need this done. We need this done. But once your leadership is solid there, I really do think you're going to have an extremely strong group. Your leaders are, they will not give up.
They're not going to.
They're GOGI for life.
Oh,
they're not going to give up. They're patient,
mm-hmm.
and they're not whining about it. They're just saying, okay, we need this. We want this.
Mm-hmm.
What can we do in the interim? That's why your in-cell studies, your numbers on in-cell are high on C.
High on C facility.
Mm-hmm.
Well, that's good to hear that.
Yeah.
And yet, trust me, guys, she does. I get emails during late at night.
Yes, you do.
On Saturdays, Sundays. Coach Taylor truly is in the GOGI and making High Desert successful and giving us information. So, you know, believe me that, yeah. She is up late at night correcting papers and those kind of things and
yes,
sending emails to the warden.
Yes, I am. But you also have answered mm-hmm. some late night emails too.
Yes,
so
I
we're
have.
Both down for High Desert men.
Yes, we are. We're here to help these men be better people and know that they can positively program at the prison. And again, I'm thankful for that.
Yeah. Yeah, it's kind of cool.
And now we drift over to our Delta facility,
right.
which had the in-building. We know there
mm-hmm.
was a few roadblocks because they went to an expanded yard, which
yes.
they had requested of us.
Yes.
And I know that Captain Zampano and his team was able to get that reinstated, I think, 3 weeks ago, our in-building and so forth.
Mm-hmm.
So how are those guys doing when the last time your visit was here?
Well, I think they too miss their leadership meetings. It's
mm-hmm.
like having a bunch of guys with a lot of tools, but not having the instructor to teach you how to use them.
Correct.
We do need our leaders meeting once a week. They aren't meeting either. So, but it's okay because they're still resilient.
Mm-hmm.
They're still doing their in-buildings. We're sending a lot of stuff back that we need redone because
mm-hmm.
they don't have that steerage. They don't have the leadership that is kind of at the foundation of the success. They
mm-hmm.
don't have that peer support.
Mm-hmm.
But once we get those weekly meetings up, they're all doing GOGI. Everybody there is doing GOGI.
Well, they are.
Yeah, yes. They're all doing it in cell and in their small meetings anytime they can.
Well, that
they
is good.
Hunger for the leadership.
Well, hunger
meeting.
For leadership.
Yes,
so we got to get
yes.
that leadership meeting going back.
Yes,
we'll work
yes.
with Captain Zampano on that.
Yes.
Yeah. And then last, I'll ask you as far as before you kind of ask me some questions, is how is it going in Z Unit? I know our facility, Z Unit, Dr. McIntosh, and you talked, and she introduced
right.
that into that right. Short-term restrictive housing. Has there been any interest there with the guys
we
there?
We are returning 3 completed mm-hmm. courses to mm-hmm. Z Unit guys.
Mm-hmm.
Anybody from Z Unit can do GOGI. In fact, anyone anywhere can do GOGI.
Correct.
We don't have any restriction. So anybody can write to the CRM, a 22, saying, I want GOGI. Anybody at High Desert, and in most prisons now, mm-hmm. they can write to the CRM and ask
Correct.
Either for incel, small group, or the ILTEG.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, we welcome them.
I got you. Well, that's a population that kind of we, you know, want to make sure that they don't get left out at all.
Right.
So we've even kind of put our transitions class in there for 12 guys in there. So,
awesome.
You know, with the GOGI in there, helping yes. people make positive changes, belly breathing, learning different techniques
yeah.
and so forth to make positive decisions. And then with our transitions, we hope
yeah.
to have that population really kind of come around, and hopefully our Z Unit short-term restrictive housing population will decrease as people, you know,
right.
can program positively.
Right. Well, at some point, maybe our next visit or the visit after that, I'd mm-hmm. love to go door-to-door at Z and just
okay.
enroll them. Just get them going. So wherever they go after that,
mm-hmm.
they get to take their GOGI with them.
That might be a good thing, because a lot of times when people are in segregated housing, they kind of get into a certain routine
right.
and kind of
right.
maybe even sometimes give up on themselves.
Yeah.
This would be nice for you guys to go in there and just say, no, here's what you need to do. Get them back focused,
yeah.
and then hopefully they'll sign up and take advantage of GOGI.
Well, I know I've told you that our strongest leaders came out of Pelican Bay D Unit, SHU.
Oh, okay.
Strongest leaders.
Strongest leaders come out of
because they had the most time to study the material.
Yeah, they are a captivated audience, so they
yes.
can study.
Yes, yeah. When you have time to really work on the material, you realize how powerful these tools are.
Correct.
So the Z Unit guys, they have time to focus on, wow, how can I use this tool to make me the best man or best woman that I can be?
Mm-hmm.
You know, anybody that's kind of away from all the drama,
correct.
They have an awesome opportunity mm-hmm. to make all sorts of corrections and emerge as a new person.
A new person.
Yeah, doing things the GOGI way.
The GOGI way, that's good. How, in closing off Delta Yard and so forth, have mm-hmm. you had much interaction with your GOGI, the GOGI NA group at all? Anything information on that, or is it
no,
you're still in the opening stages?
You know, I don't know,
mm-hmm.
And I don't know who's running it, but
okay.
we do encourage anybody who's doing NA or AA to integrate the GOGI tools into their meeting.
Okay.
In fact, actually, any group. Our vets group here has mm-hmm. integrated GOGI. Mm-hmm. We want to supply this information to any group doing anything.
Correct.
Anybody who wants to do GOGI integrated into what you're doing will be more than happy to support you in that.
I got you. And how is, I think you guys are putting together something for the GOGI Veterans book off
yes.
of Facility B. Is that moving along?
It's so awesome. The GOGI vets actually mm-hmm. looked at the GOGI tools and how could these tools help them be a better soldier?
Correct.
A better civilian once they return
to our,
civilian life.
To our communities.
And if they've committed a crime and if they're doing time, wherever it is, how can they integrate what they know as a military service person
mm-hmm.
and utilizing the GOGI tools to be a leader in their new community?
Hmm.
We'll take that all day long. It's
yes,
called
ma'am.
Winning the War Within.
Winning the War Within. Well, okay.
Yeah.
Well, we appreciate that.
Yeah, and your vets on A and B have been instrumental in contributing to that.
Well, that's good. I appreciate those guys' help with that.
Yeah.
Got some good good guys here who are here to, you know, do the right thing and
yeah.
assist GOGI and help it to continue on and for High Desert to be the flagship and
yes.
move Pleasant Valley kind of to second
you want to
place.
Be position one.
Position one.
I think we'll get more than 2,000 completions by the end of the year.
Okay.
And I think we're well on track to meet mm-hmm. some pretty serious goals.
Well, that's good. I'm glad that you appreciate you guys taking a chance on us and actually coming back. I know it's a long drive and flight for you guys.
Yes,
lot
it is.
Lot involved with it, but you know.
Yes, it is.
Again, to me, it was worth it.
Yes,
and
big time.
You guys have made some major, major changes in our population. I was seeing how they can make better decisions.
Yeah.
When things come upon them in prison and also for them, as they're preparing to reintegrate back into society.
Yeah, I remember at one of the graduations you said that you want them to be good neighbors.
Yes, I do.
Yeah.
I want them to be a very good neighbor. Because, again, you know, I have family members all throughout California. and so forth. So if they're around my family members at, you know, different, you know, recreational activities, if they go to a college around my family members, mm-hmm. or if they're out having dinner, or right. whatever the case is, we want them to be able to have a skill set to make, you know, positive decisions and right. so forth as they interface and get back into society.
Absolutely. So you tell them that you want them to be a good neighbor, and I further that by mm-hmm. saying they are the solution. The problem in their communities, they represent what could be the solution.
Oh, they do. Okay.
So when they go home and they become a good neighbor, that mm-hmm. is being the solution. And if they utilize their tools, they're going to be home free and keep their freedom internally and externally.
And externally.
Yes.
Well, that's good to see.
I'm so grateful you gave us your time. It's just so wonderful. I know you've got a busy day. You'll be here probably 15, 16 hours. You're here 15, 16 hours every day of the week. And if the men only knew how much time you invested and how much you cared about their success, I think you wouldn't have not one 115 on this,
right.
this
well,
institution.
That, well, that is our goal, to reduce 115s, to reduce incidences, and to reduce appeals.
Yes.
And just get everybody here to come here. Because you and I have talked before, I think probably 85 to 90% of, you know, our offender population, and most prisons, including here, everybody just wants to come here and just do their time.
Right.
And then we expose them to GOGI,
right.
where they can learn those positive tools, you know, to be successful and to program successfully in prison and to get back outside and so forth. And the other 10%, we're trying to, they're kind of kicking and screaming, but we're going to drag them in, we're going to drag them into the fold with everybody else.
Absolutely.
Do you have any questions of me? And I've kind of asked you some questions. You have any questions
of Warden,
me?
No, Warden, you're just awesome. We really appreciate you. You've supported us from the very beginning. You get the vision that we want these individuals to be home and be very good next door neighbors. You get that.
Yeah.
You support it and you encourage it among the men. And for that, we're very grateful.
Well, again, I'm grateful and thankful to you guys for taking a chance. Again, I'm saying it again, on High Desert, the prison, you know, had a reputation of being a pretty rough level 4 prison. It is a maximum security prison, but I've seen the offender population change, where our violence is down across the board and our incidents are down.
Great.
Of course, we do have things that take place, unfortunately, because it is a maximum security prison.
Right.
But I think for the most part, most people have kind of understood that, you know, between you coming here and then my support of them to be better men and make better decisions, that people are actually, you know, I'll say drank the Kool-Aid, and they're actually doing the right thing. And that's what we're looking for.
And that's why we're getting the emails from the family saying, thank you, I have my husband back, or I've got my dad back, or I can't believe this is the man, he's wonderful, you know. That's the kind of feedback we're getting on our Facebook page, on our emails, and our phone calls, is gratitude from the family for the work that's being done.
Well, that I'm glad to hear that. So we're being successful.
Yes.
And that's the main thing. We're going to be successful here at this prison.
Yeah, for sure. So we're going to be back next month. And we're going to catch up on seeing our men, letting them screen some of their graduation footage, which we will probably include in one of our e-learning courses. So you guys are going to be superstars.
Yes, they will be.
Thank you
especially
very much.
Especially with all of your energy that you put into it. They're going to be
they're not going to fail. No, there's no way.
That's right. One thing I'll say to them, because they're going to be looking at this, is failure is not an option.
No, it's not.
It's not an option. So if you're going to be at a high desert, you're going to be a man, and you're going to take advantage of GOGI and any other rehabilitative services to be successful.
Success has never been easier than it is right now.
Well, that's good. It's going to stay that way.
Yes, for sure.
One last question I'll ask you. The tone of kind of, let me know, we've talked about it, most of the custody officers on most of the facilities in there, how is their kind of take and interaction with you guys with GOGI and your...
Okay, when I first came here in 2015, it was rough.
Okay.
It was really rough. And then, person by person by person by person, they started seeing the benefits of the programming, or the benefits of a different way of communication. Now I've got to say 99% of your custody, awesome supporters of programming. And now they are saying, well, this guy could be my neighbor.
Correct.
I've got to invest in him understanding. Your custody is superior. Superior. And I've said emails just like that to headquarters to say, the custody, the environment of custody is now so supportive of getting these individuals to be the very best they can be.
Okay. Well, that is good
Isn't
to
that
hear.
cool?
That is cool and good to hear. And I know, again, like you've shared with me and all the custody stuff, GOGI is kind of a custody tool.
Yes, it is a tool.
So I think our staff have embraced it. And like, again, like I taught, like I, when I teach in the off-post training, like I taught today, we have the ISB number for the, many of your GOGI books.
Yes.
And some of our staff have actually ordered some of the books. And some of our staff also, you have given me a few of the How to GOGI book, and I've actually given it to staff. So they can, and some people say they're using some of the concepts, you know, to help them out as they navigate around the prison and, you know, interface with, you know, one another and with our offender population here.
Right. Yeah. It's kind of cool. We're changing things, getting it going the GOGI way.
Getting it going the GOGI way.
Thank you very much, Warden.
Well, thank you, Coach Taylor.
Appreciate
and anytime
it.
You want to talk to me, just feel free to commandeer me and say, hey, we want to talk to you.
Okay. Wonderful.
All right.
Hey, did you get that? We got an exclusive interview with the warden. I am so excited, and you get to be the first to see it. I'm really, really happy and proud of what we're doing at High Desert, but not just High Desert. GOGI is blowing up everywhere, and you are a part of it. Do your assignments, fill in every line, turn in your course book, get your credit, and then keep going. Because remember, it takes 10,000 times to repeat anything before you're an expert. And we want you to be an expert at being a good neighbor, an expert at making positive decisions, and we want you to live your life the GOGI way. Thanks for watching.